You see my tree? There it is. Okay, so I don't know where to begin. I mean, everything I said about it this afternoon, and I just started decorating. You know, I love decorating. All my favorite thing on earth is to get decorations and then decorate them. So, well, basically, I just put up all the lights all the way down. I just got them from the Japan Home Center. Yeah, and I decided on this tree. This tree because, I don't know, I mean, it's nicer. It's only like $100, which is like, I don't know, it's like maybe a little more than 12 bucks. It's great. I just love this. So I decided to keep the berries, these berries on, but then I put in all these, I stuck in all these ones that I talked about before. I just put them all over. I decided not to like cut them up. Like, why should I snip them up when it's like so gorgeous? I just love this. So I wanted like a really sort of white Christmas theme, but not completely white. So I used these transparent baubles. I made them very obvious because the light would like shine through. Then I decided not to go with the I decided not to go with the rose gold baubles, like the solid rose gold, because they're pretty solid. Like they're pretty solid. So I stuck with these ones. They're like kind of dusted with like a sort of a rose sparkle. I stuck with these. I kept these beautiful transparent ones. Then this afternoon I went to Bed and Bath and I got some of these. Look at this. This one is so beautiful. I got a couple of these, and this one, so nice. Look how it hangs down. All the details. Then of course these ones that I have in previous years, a couple of these. Then also of course these. I'm turning down the music. Then also yesterday from Great, I got a bunch of these nice ones. I like them because they're kind of glittery, sparkly, a little like, I don't know, like, it looks crystalline, you know? Kind of like the light can seep through. Then of course this one, see this one, this beautiful white one. Yeah, more, look at this one is gorgeous. Yeah, so this is how my tree looks for now. Turn on some lights. So, I was thinking though of what to put up. Can you see me? What to put up top? Up top here. I was I'm choosing between a couple of options. So maybe. So today I got. I got four of these beautiful ones from the store. So I got four of these. I was thinking I could just maybe like bunch them up, like kind of like this, but like four times over, and then put it up top instead of like a star, because the stars I have, you see my stuff. Stuff I haven't put up yet. I don't want the tree like too gaudy, you know? Like, I don't know, like sometimes a tree just by itself, you know, just naked with, you know, really sparkly. It's really beautiful, but like, because of my taste and I have such beautiful baubles, I decided to decorate. But, yeah, so I have one of these. No, I have two of these. I have this. I really like this. I bought it because I thought this meant it would have a light bulb underneath, which would make like the top of the tree sort of sparkle. It doesn't though, so then it's sort of like, it's like a little girl decorating a tree, you know? But like this Christmas, I sort of feel like a little girl because it's a pandemic and I sort of feel lonely. Like I was telling my mom this afternoon, like I really miss seeing my good friends, and I really miss going to like my super fancy parties with my really close friends. So I kind of wanted to recreate the feeling with my tree at home. And this is like it's a little childish, you know, like we don't have a child here, so I didn't want to put up a star on top. So that's why I got these to make me feel better for them, and then maybe put them up top. But I'm still sort of shopping around, you know, it's a couple days till Christmas. But yeah, so this is, you want to see again? Yeah, this is how Christmas in paradise looks. Just kidding. Look at all this. This. All the way down to here. This. Yeah, these. Look. Oh, and these. These. I also got these. These. I think I mentioned these already. I got them yesterday or the day before at the great store. And so I don't know what to do about the other tree, the four foot, not the 4 foot, the one from the online store where I searched for it. Like you have to search for it. I asked the store owner, who was so kind, and said they accept returns, but I think they said I couldn't exchange it or something. Read the message in detail. They said they won't give me something else, but I can send it back to them, which I assume means that they they might give me my money back. I don't know. See? Welcome to Christmas. Christmas by the holidays. Christmas done by the holidays. That's so funny. Yeah, I miss my sister. Sometimes I wonder if my mom is like being a little silly. When I was asking her this afternoon which of the two types of lights she preferred, and she said she liked the one that was warmer, with a warmer glow. Maybe that's what she meant. But honestly though, I think what she means is that she likes these lights I chose from the Japan Home Center, just because, well, I pictured them earlier today at the lower part of the tree, and it just it seems lower, but you know, it's got like a glow to it. It's not like a hot yellow glow. It's very like cool in like a collegiate sort of a cool, like a collegiate cool. Very uniform. They all look the same. Matches perfectly with all the stuff out there that, you know, is bright and sparkly and beautiful. Yeah, I don't know. I don't regret anything about having these beautiful decorations. I mean, my dad was saying earlier today that, you know, he was worried like about the center of gravity, because he said with the tree the problem is up top, the upper branches at the top are like sort of nice and short, but the branches down below at the bottom are kind of too long. So that's why when you like unbundle the tree, like you open it up and it unravels, then the center of gravity like drops lower. And when it drops lower, then like that sort of might stabilize the tree, like, you know, in case you're worried that it's weak and it's weak down there, it's weak, you know, on its foundation, and so maybe it might, you know, like topple downwards, fall downwards instead of, you know, I don't know, fall some other direction, you know, fall into heaven, fall in love, or none of the above, just falling downwards, you know, like a spiraling, like a collapse, you know, like a toppling over, you know, not like a failing, like falling down, like someone tripping over, or like a company going bust. Just talking about a natural tree that sort of might be like heavy, but I don't think so. It looks fine to me. I was worried that it would get too heavy, and like I said, the four legs at the bottom, like a little bit worrisome. But my dad told me that, you know, if I had planned on getting some heavy metal, it would be hard to attach the heavy metal to the bottom of the tree. Like, you know, how would you just drag a piece of like loaded heavy metal, like a piece of heavy metal, and just forcibly stick it to the bottom of the tree? You know, it's not, it might be hard, maybe, I don't know, maybe compatibility issues, I don't know. But it's Christmas, and, you know, I'm in charge of the holidays, so I just wanted to show my friends, you know, the tree that's designed by me. I miss everybody so much. Yeah. I don't know what I like the most. I think, well, I like this the most because I had it before. And I like these, the Christmas berries, because it's like, it's just really ornate, you know? Like, if it's just like these small berries, like sort of scattered all over, I decided not to like snip it, because then it just looks so like full and so pretty, you know? And it's a little bit cute, because it's very small, you know, like a little bit cute. A little bit cute. I like these ones because of the shape. It's so nice and it's like a little sparkly. Of course I like this one because it's like, it's white, but it's sort of, you know, it's like, I don't know, it's like, it's got like, well, I also put it like, you know, next to each other, next to the berries, because it's got these small like pearls, you know, and then it like sort of matches these. Then of course these, just because the coloring, it just goes so well. I'm just wondering if I should get like more more stuff. I don't know how I could decorate this more unless I sort of like, you know, I don't know how I could, you see, I don't know, how could I decorate this more? I don't know. Just, I guess, like, you know, just keep thinking of how to make this part, you know, just continuously more and more nice, you know? I mean, I don't wanna, it's just an apartment tree. It's not about making, like, the world's most extravagant, you know, ornate, beautiful thing. It's not about that. It's just, I don't know, I love making things beautiful. Oh, and the roses. The 9 roses from the online store. They arrived, but not, see, you can see, right? like not really like champagne. Not really champagne, kind of. Yeah, it is white. Like, I wanted to get them because otherwise, what, you'd only choose from, I think, what, orange, red, and one other one. Orange, red, what was the other one? Orange, red, white. I don't remember the last color, but yeah, only two of them, a little bit champagne-y. The rest, like the seven, really white. So I don't know where I could put them. Oh, so I was thinking though, what to put at the bottom of the tree. So yesterday at Great, I got kind of like, not regular tissue paper, but like really, really nice, like with a little bit of like sparkles on it. I don't know how they did it. Like with the like sort of a silvery sheen. Maybe they just like, I don't know, like put some powdered glitter over it or something. It just looks somewhat shiny, but you can't really tell. So I got like 5 or 6 packs of those, and I'm thinking of using that to wrap the like as if presents. So maybe just get some old boxes, old like, I don't know, like maybe stack like a couple of encyclopedias together and then just wrap them up in that tissue paper, like in multiple layers, so it looks really pretty. So then at the bottom it's all like a snowy white, but still it's actually all boxes of presents, same colors. And then I was thinking of wrapping them up with like bows, which are like sort of silvery gray bows. And then those like boxed presents would line the bottom of the tree. That's what I'm thinking. I don't know, actually. I'm not sure I want to put those four like shiny bunches of flowers up on the top of the tree, because a little shiny and you put it up top, like, you know, you go to like nice hotel lobbies, and I really like the background where like you put like kind of silvery, like shimmery structured branches up the top of the tree, so it looks like, you know, almost like it's like a crown, like it's got a tiara on top. But I don't think it's very likable for like a tree for the home to have like a tiara, like a crown on its head. You know, it's not, I don't like that. I want like a really elegant, really like classy, but still really extravagant, really perfect, everything matches sort of a tree decor, and still like very silvery white. So I got rid of, I couldn't use the rose gold solid baubles because, yeah, they are pretty, they seem pretty solid. They're pretty solid, so, you know, they're pretty solid. They're pretty solid. Yeah. Yeah, but my dad, oh, speaking of solidity, solidarity, no, solidity, is that a word? My dad was telling me not to worry too much about that tree, because although it's like put together in like maybe 3 pieces, they seem pretty solid, so unfortunately it's you can't break them up. You can't break them up. But yeah. feeling a little happier because I have like a tree up. I'm so happy. I found it on the Sassy Hong Kong website. I was just looking for trees because I wasn't very happy with the one that arrived from Discovery Mall, because it was like just looking really like empty. It just looked, I don't know, it looked like it was about to topple over, like
I don't know, like the person who was doing nothing but ordering food, ordering delivery for food, you know, like just stuck in an office doing work and then you know, talking to one girlfriend every day and then ordering food from the delivery, online delivery. That was the sort of tree it looked like. It's not holidays, you know, it's not holidays. It's not like holidays, like, you know, done up by, you know, like someone who's been a little girl, you know, like literally just a holiday kind of. So I'm so glad because that website, Sassy Hong Kong, told me about the Japan Home Center. And it's just really convenient because just like discoverymall.net, it's very like the prices, so like, you know, just consumer friendly. It's been very convenient for me during the pandemic, you know, with my parents giving me very little pocket money. I'm just so appreciative that all the, you know, the supermarket and then these two online stores, well, no, the online store and then the Japan Home Center, they sell things that just really like, really like consumer friendly pricing, so that even people like me can buy, you know, things and then make it look like the way I would normally. the way I would normally. So I'm just so appreciative, you know. Yeah, I don't know how it's possible. Yeah, so the store 2 days ago, Japan Home Center, they sell like everything sourced from Japan, but it looks like a convenience store. Like, you know, it's just really easy, kind of like just the up the hill from Central Wellington Street, I think. Doesn't look like, you know, it's like walking into a Best Buy kind of thing. Yeah. Yeah, it's great. Oh, and great's been really helpful. Oh, yeah, so yesterday or the day before at Great, I got also these. Ooh, where is it? The ribbon, like I think five. I don't know if it's 5 feet or 5 yards. I'm worried about the length. The ribbon. Love my tree. The ribbon. Oh, here it is. See, this is a perfect, like, perfectly tinged color. Perfect tinge of like sort of sparkly transparent, except I think it's only, see, and I got it for only, it's very high quality, but you know, I got a 30% off, 25 Hong Kong dollars, so $3 US. So this whole tree, you know, the tree itself maybe 12 bucks US dollars, $3 for the ribbons, each bauble newly bought only no more than 10 bucks, 10 like US dollars. It's just a very, very convenient Christmas. Yeah. I don't know how it happens that it's, you know, really, really, you know, consumer friendly, you know? It's almost like it's kid friendly stores. Yeah, and at the supermarket I go to, there are two lanes for like the supermarket trolleys, supermarket carts. And one lane on the left is usually for like 4-year-olds who want to go shopping. You can go on the left side and pick up a trolley, like a cart, that's maybe one foot tall. And then if you're an adult, you go to the right side and you pick up a regular cart. Although I noticed yesterday at the supermarket, they switched the sides. So if you're like a 4-year-old going shopping on your own and you want to get a shopping cart that's only 1 to 2 feet tall, then instead of going to the left, you go to the right. Yeah, then if you're an adult, you go to the left to pick up a shopping cart of regular height. Yeah, very strange. I don't know. But yeah. So my current concern, my current worry, not the current concern. I'm wondering if, because it does say this item, two and a half inches by oh, 5 yards. 5 yards. Oh, okay, maybe I'll be okay. Oh, I was so scared of it. Okay. Maybe I'll be okay because I was thinking, okay, here's what I'm thinking. What I'm thinking is like one, like not cutting things up and making any bows, but just one big swirl, like diagonally downwards, swirling around the tree, but not too like, not too obvious and not like really maybe thin spirals, because then it might be too obvious, cover the beauty of all my baubles, or maybe somehow spiral them inward so that it doesn't go like on the outer edges of the tree, sort of stick them inside the middle of the tree, but you can sort of see hints of it, just like, you know, just like curls, like when you curl your hair and going downwards. So I was thinking of doing that, just one long, you know, sort of like one long curly thing going downwards to the bottom. Yeah, that should pretty much, yeah, you know, it's like how I do anything, I just want to keep making it more like perfect, but not always aware that it has to not look gaudy. But see, one rule of not going overboard is that you have a color scheme. If the color scheme is nicely done, you can't really make it too busy because everything's sort of matchy-matchy. Yeah, it's about, for me, I think the color scheme, if everything is sort of easily matched together, it's hard to go wrong. That's the first thing. So that's why I picked this color of the lights. Yeah. Yeah, same with all the other types of decorations, like the Christmas berries and like the small items, like the glittery looking, like crystal looking presents, you know, that I hung up, that I showed. You know, all the baubles, sort of a rough kind of like a transparent slash sparkly, but you can't really say what color it is. It's not like a solid silver or solid gold. So if you stick to those rules, then everything, it never becomes too much. It never becomes too much, you know? Though I decided not to make it like a totally white Christmas tree where everything is like a, not a transparent white, but everything really white, like snowflakes or stuff, because then it I don't know, it doesn't have the sparkle. You want sparkle, so it's got to be like this. I don't know. Yeah, I think I should really be done because it is a little bit dumb. I don't think it looks overboard. I don't think it looks like it's overboard. I think it's sort of, I feel like it's like just enough, you know? Yeah. If I can see. Turn off from. Yeah, maybe sort of this lighting instead, but a couple of candles, or maybe put a dimmer on, or maybe like a dimmer light so that everything you can just see like all the details up close. And yeah, so now I have to think about also the rest of the apartment, what to do. I don't know. A lot to think about. Yeah. Yeah, I feel a little happier after putting this up. Yeah. So, okay, it's almost 30 minutes. I think I'm gonna go to bed now. So I ordered in kind of a long day of decorating. So I got some, I think this is 유향캐지 이민. And then I got a 수초의 욕시 수초의 포 앞시 먼마이 so yummy, because you know, growing up in Hong Kong, I can't live without my, you know, wonderfully greasy Chinese food, you know. It's not as good as the ones my ones they make at home, but still. Then I ordered a soup, like a thick soup. I ordered a what was it? Some sort of a but then like it got here and I think they put the lid on really loosely, so like it just spilled. See, there's like a stain on my carpet now. Yeah. I wanted to order chocolates too, but then they said they wouldn't deliver chocolates. I don't know, maybe the time of day or something. Yeah, I'm just thinking the last time I went to like a group event was back in January. Back in January before the pandemic. And I went to the Hong Kong Food Expo. And it was so fun. Except shortly afterwards it was the coronavirus. And then all that kind of stuff just ended. Just stopped. But yeah, I miss talking to local people about anything. Yeah. Ooh, I'm gonna turn some lights back on because I look like right. Yeah. So still a lot of work to be done. Right? More work on the tree. I'm thinking maybe if I just, you know, have time and want to look more busy, then get a couple more of the transparent, semi-transparent baubles. Because you can't go wrong. It won't become like a purely white Christmas, but like, you know, the Christmas sparklies would seep through the color. So it would just look decorated. Then I have to put the marble wallpaper on this. I love this, but for the holidays, I'm taking a photo, so I'm going to just, you know, put it on. I don't think I'm going to stick it on, like, the bottom of it. Like, just put some tape at the bottom and then just layer it on so I can still take it off afterwards and have this. Same with, you know, everything else. Like, I was talking about just pasting some... Yeah, the wallpaper by the piano also. Gonna put the Amazon wallpaper on that. Because I like it. It's like marbly. It looks just like the marble just like the marble in my bathroom. Yeah, so everything's gonna go really nicely. You know, think of what to do with sort of this area of the apartment. Just put some, you know, small pillows, cushions, something like that. Make it look a little cozier, a little nicer. Maybe like tape the paper on the edges of the windows, so then it looks like it frames the frames of the windows would match everything. I'm thinking also that, like, if I just have lots of free time, you know. I don't know what to do. Yeah, it's just a lot of just tidying up. But tidying up for me is just very quick, you know, just really quickly, just very quickly. Yeah. Yeah. I like this top. It's a new top I got from Ted Baker. See, it's got the detail here. It's got stitches of baby blue. And the, see over here, the collar. Really lovely, lovely pattern. I love this. Yeah. Long day. Long day. Not hardly any makeup today. I know people think it's like weird or something. Wonder if I like have eyeshadow. No, never. I don't put any. Just a little, like a little of the mascara. That's all I put. I don't really have eyebrows, so I
sort of, you know, I don't like to make them look like they're drawn though. I like the details to show. But yeah, nothing here. Yeah, no blush, nothing red, nothing here. I just have like rosy cheeks for some reason. I feel a little warm. I don't know why. Yeah. Nothing. Just a little shadow right here. Nothing else. I don't even use concealer, so you can see my freckles. Can you see my freckles? See my freckles? Yeah, no concealer. Like literally a small dab of makeup. Like this small liquid and just a really, really thin layer. Just like with sunblock. That's all I put. No lipstick. Just the pencil with a little bit of the color stain on top. I decided to go for this look today. Simple look. Yeah. Yeah, I'm quite satisfied with the tree. I guess, you know, pretty much how I want it to look in that I think I can see the picture in my mind. And it came out exactly as I wanted it. You know, a little sparkly, but not being able to decipher between gold or silver, and a lot of transparency, a lot of detail, a lot of sparkle though, and kind of on the theme of a white Christmas, but not, you know, like artificial snow kind of. Yeah, and really fancy and ornate, but still classy and not like childish or you know, gaudy. This is the design I had been thinking of, and it really just came out this way. Just a little more on the top, I have to think about it. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this makes me think of a song I'm practicing right now, which sounds like a Christmas tree. So it's called like forest murmur of a forest or something. Oh, my hands are so cold, not warm. It's by Liszt. It's by this composer called Liszt. Very sparkly. It's good for people with my sort of little hands with very strong fingers. You know, very, very sparkly, really pretty, really angly, really, I don't know, like kind of clean, you know, like clean, but not like a squeaky clean, you know, like for children kind of clean, but like still you can see all the, you know, see all the stuff. Yeah. Yeah. See, I'm like a holiday specialist, so everything I do is holidays.
holiday songs, holiday designs.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, yeah. I still have a lot to work on. So much to work on. That wasn't very good. It wasn't very good. It should be like, yeah. You see, I don't know. I could never teach someone how to play piano. But like regularly, you should like maybe think, you know, for a moment. Think for just one moment before, you know, just think of like how you want to do it at the character, you know, and then go. So. You have to play you make the effect by putting your fingers together. Can you see? It's not, you know, you're not just playing one finger at the same time. You like with one hand or on both hands, you're actually moving like multiple, you know? I don't know, it's very easy for me to do it. See? Can you see? My first teacher told me to. See? So then it comes out like really, you know, you practice it really sparkly, you know? So then it's. It like kind of like, you know, with strong fingers, but the hardest part is at the end when you have to make it really soft, you know. I don't know, because you have to make it really, really strong, the knuckles really angular, so that you can still play it really, really soft, so you don't hit the keys with force, because it's very easy to do, you know, it's very easy, but it's much harder. And then, you know,
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, it's just so, it's so nice and easy. Yeah, so that's what I'm up to for a pandemic Christmas. It's, you know, getting things warmed up. Yeah, I'm gonna go to bed now.